Le Bureau de Visibilité de Calgary is excited to bring you La French Connection Calgary, where guests are invited to share their fascinating stories and raison d'être in English and or en français, with content in Cree, Michif, Blackfoot, and other native languages of Canada.
Bienvenue and welcome to La French Connection Calgary. I'm Marc Lalonde, here on location at the beautiful Calgary Immigrant Educational Society Welcome Center with some special guests. We have Dr. Sally Zhou, who is the Chief Executive Officer at the Society, and John Lee, who's Vice President on the board. Welcome. Or I suppose I'm the one who should be welcome because we're in your building,
you.
Aren't we? Yes, it's quite the facility,
well.
Quite nice. So let's get right into it. The Calgary Immigrant Educational Society. When did it start? What does it do, Sally?
Calgary Immigrant Educational Society started in 1988. It was founded by a person named Salim Sindhu, and unfortunately he passed away in 2014. And we offer, in total, we offer about 30 programs in language training, employment, and settlement services.
Hmm. Okay, and you started up with someone providing the initial financing. I imagine it started fairly small and then it grew over the course of the last 3 years?
Yeah, we started very small with Salim and plus a few volunteers. And we are renting, you know, an office, very small office. And at the very beginning, no financial support from our side. And I think everything just kind of come from donations from individuals and plus a lot of volunteer work. And now we are offering the services and in 3 locations.
In 3 locations.
Yes.
So this location, which is in the northeast, just off 32nd and 32nd.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's one in the southeast, I understand, on 40th?
Yeah, we have another location in the southeast Forest Lawn area.
Mm-hmm.
And we also lately opened in August the West Wind location. So now we offer the services in 3 locations.
Okay. How many employees does the society have?
We have about 190 employees and over 200 volunteers.
Oh, wow.
We're serving about 1,400 clients every week.
Every week?
Every week, and about 130 children in the child care program.
My goodness, yes. Mm-hmm. So it must be busy. It must get quite noisy here at times.
Very busy, every day.
Okay. We'll come back to a little bit more details in a moment.
Sure.
Let's switch over to John. John, you're on the board. How did you get involved?
So I think I started about 4 years ago, just prior to the unfortunate passing of Dr. Sindhu. So I actually started, as Sally mentioned, there's kind of 3 silos, if you will. I was more involved in, call it the education / the employment training side. So I was actually a volunteer. I started as a volunteer here in one of their programs. I was kind of a guest speaker, if you will, of sorts. And eventually I was... long story short, I was invited to the AGM, and they were in need of people to step up to the slate, so kind of one thing left to another, led to another, and the rest is kind of history. I don't actually recall when I became vice president of the board, but I remember it wasn't too long after that. There was a need to kind of reshuffle some roles there, and I was asked, and I said, okay, well, what does it mean? And sure.
Right. So what does it mean to be vice president?
I think... It really, so our president, Melissa, she lives in...
What's her full name?
Melissa Edwards. And she's been a volunteer since the very get-go. So in my own words, I think a part of the role is actually learning as much as I can from her. And then collectively, it's just supporting society and most importantly, Sally in, you know, whatever role that it necessitates at the time, right? I used to work very close to her, so I used to just kind of come by on demand. It was very, very convenient for myself and everybody involved. So it's really just being there and available to answer any questions, but most importantly, like I said, just to support Sally, ensuring that she has, you know, my number and I'm accessible as often as I can be.
So someone to bounce ideas off of and perhaps to fill in for her when she can't be there?
Yeah, I mean, that's more or less what I think we're all kind of here to do is to serve as, you know, cold eye review when necessary. And as well, if there's any ideas that need to be bounced off of us, then for sure. I mean, there's a lot of, you know, ad hoc things that come on the fly, if you will. And yeah, it's just being available, having that kind of second look or second opinion on things. So
what motivates you to keep doing it?
I guess, like, at the beginning, it's I'm an immigrant myself to Calgary. I came here in 1990, so not too long after society was established, right? And you know, just kind of over the years, I witnessed, you know, my parents and family friends kind of firsthand how they kind of struggled. And when I first heard about this place, I literally just came by and said, you know, who can I talk to about getting involved? Because I think what we do here is so impactful. I mean, you almost have to experience it to really appreciate what it means. But I think it's just about kind of paying it forward, because I've seen some of the struggles that others have had trying to figure out, you know, what to do, where they can turn to for help, and just not even knowing, you know, where that safe place is. And I think, you know, if you take a look around, I think there's a propensity for people to focus on what actually divides us. And I think it's really nice to have a place that, you know, in a nutshell, I think it serves to bring people together and focus on that togetherness and that inclusiveness. And I'd like to think that, you know, we can remain kind of committed to that mission, if you will, over time. So that's kind of how I got involved, and that's what
brings me here. See how that would be gratifying, you bet. Absolutely. So it's a real welcome center that you have in these places, mm-hmm. that people can keep coming back. And
yes.
And so, Sally, can you give us a little bit of information about what the society has planned, what it's doing now? I understand mm-hmm. you recently had the gala.
Yes.
For the 30th anniversary mm-hmm. of the society. That's quite the accomplishment. Mm-hmm. What was that like?
Well, actually, and this year, because the society was established in 1988, so, and we are celebrating our 30th anniversary, as you mentioned, in October 30th, and it is the society's 30th birthday. So on October 30th, and we had our, you know, big gala with 300, you know, attendees, and including a few politicians, the Lieutenant Governor General, you know, and Lieutenant Governor of Alberta was there.
Okay, so you've made an impression at all kinds of levels. Are you getting some support from the government?
We do. We receive funding from three levels of government, and federal government, provincial, and municipal, and also and foundations like United Way, Calgary Learns, Calgary Foundation, First Calgary Financial, and TD Bank. So and also anonymous donors. We do receive, you know, fundings from, you know, both government and foundations.
Mm-hmm. What can we look forward to from the society in the months and years to come? Mm-hmm. What have you got in your back pocket that you're going to be revealing soon?
Actually, and you know, as I mentioned, we are offering more than 30 programs, and some of the programs are offered in classroom setting, some of online. So, and with the years, and we have been growing and very fast, and also the scope of services have been expanded as well to and reflect, you know, the expansion of the programs and services, and also the scope of services, and board has decided, you know, to, and it's time now to have a name change and a new logo as well. Ah. So, and in 2019, and we are in the procedures now to and complete all the steps, like talking to the funders and CRA and also registration, and we're expecting to reveal our new name and the new logo in 2019.
Oh, that will be exciting, won't it? Mm-hmm. Yes, changing all of that. So something that's perhaps rolls off the tongue a little easier than Calgary Immigrant Educational Society mm-hmm. of Calgary.
But of course, we're going to tweak a little bit about the appearance, but still our vision and mission will stay the same. And as I mentioned, we have about 190 staff and 200 volunteers. So 400 of us committed, and, you know, group of people very dedicated. You know, we continue to serve and embrace the diversity, inclusive, and, you know, society. We keep, you know, the same mission, vision, and the core value as well. And, you know, caring and including empowerment and service that was remain the same.
The challenges that you address or help immigrants to address, have they changed over those 30 years, or is it pretty much the same thing?
It changed over time. So, and as we offer language training, employment training, one of the changes is the population of clients, especially in the last few years. And I think Canada, as we all know, Canada has received some refugees. So, and our society because of location and the clientele. We have about 20% to 30% clients are refugees. So one of the needs we identified through serving the clients, the mental health.
Oh, yes.
So, and we call emotional well-being as well. So, and that's why we started about 3 years ago, we started to offer mental health programs. And that is really, really needed other than the, besides the language barriers and also under labor market employment funding.
All those things.
Yeah.
Right. So you're at the forefront of integrating new immigrants into the society.
Yeah.
And all that. Well, yes. that's very amazing to see that's happening. Yes.
Thank
you. And 1,400 people a week.
Yes, every week.
Every week.
Mm-hmm. We open Monday to Saturday, so 6 days a week.
Do you also do some activities that are more social, as opposed to specific structured programs?
We do, and other than offering the training, we organize field trips. So students go out, for example, to Heritage, and to Glenbow Museum, into the zoo. So to really learn about Canadian culture. We also organize events, such as every summer we have a summer festival that is open to the public. So let community know, we have services, and majority of the services in this organization are free, free of charge.
Thank you for adding that in. So if people want to get involved, to volunteer or to access the services, they go to your website?
Yeah, we have a very interactive website. Actually, we have an online chat as well. So, and all the information that you would like to know the details are on the website. And we have a volunteer program as well. So welcome, community members in all kinds of fields, like teaching, clerical work, admin work, all kinds of work, and we have volunteers.
Okay, well, thank you very much. That's been very enjoyable.
Thank you.
Very happy to have had you with us, Dr. Sally Jo.
Thank you so much.
The Chief Executive Officer of the Society, and John Lee, the Vice President. I hope you've enjoyed this little interview. Stay with us. On continue en français.